Hey, what's rockin', gentlemen and lady stockings? I'm Raven Kipling, and you're watching Raven's Real Music. Today we're going to be going over one of my all-time favorite albums, which is the Rolling Stones' Sticky Fingers. Now, I think most of you know who the Rolling Stones are, and if not, you've been living under a rock, I guess. The Rolling Stones are an English rock band that formed in London in 1962, diverging from the pop rock of the early 1960s. The Rolling Stones pioneered the gritty, heavier-driven sound that came to define hard rock. Their first stable lineup was vocalist Mick Jagger, multi-instrumentalist Brian Jones, guitarist Keith Richards, drummer Charlie Watts, and bassist Bill Wyman. During their formative years, Brian Jones was the primary leader. He put the band together, named it, and drove the sound and look of the band. After Andrew Loog Oldham became the group's manager in 63, he encouraged them to write their own songs. Jagger and Richard became the primary creative force behind the band, alienating Jones, who developed a drug addiction that interfered with his ability to meaningfully contribute. He left the band shortly before his death in 69, having been replaced by guitarist Mick Taylor, who is also a very brilliant guitarist, who in turn left in 74 to be replaced by Ronnie Wood. Since Wyman's departure in 1993, Daryl Jones has served as a bassist. Rooted in blues and early rock and roll, the Rolling Stones started out playing covers and were at the forefront of the British invasion in 1964, along with the Beatles. Also being identified with the youthful and rebellious counterculture of the 1960s, they then found greater success with their own material as I Can't Get No Satisfaction, Get Off of My Cloud, which were like the two first songs I ever heard. I got lucky to hear the Stones. My dad would switch from classic country to the rock stations when I was younger, so I think it was to give us some personality, and Paint It Black became number one hits in the UK, North America, Australia, and Europe. Aftermath, 1966, their first entirely original album, is considered the most important of their formative records. In 67, they had double-sided hit Ruby Tuesday and Let's Spend the Night Together, and then experimented with psychedelic rock on their Satanic Majesty's Request. They went back to their roots with such hits as Jumpin' Jack Flash, beautiful song, Honky Tonk Women, It's Always on My Head at Least One Time a Day, and albums such as Beggar's Banquet, 68, featuring Sympathy for the Devil and Let It Bleed, 69. You Can't Always Get What You Want and Gimme Shelter. Let It Bleed was the first of five straight number one albums in the UK in 69, and they were first introduced on stage as the greatest rock and roll band in the world, which I feel. Sticky Fingers, which we're going to be listening today, which was made in 1971, which yielded Brown Sugar, was the first of eight consecutive number one studio albums in the US for the Rolling Stones. Exile on Main Street, 1972, featuring Tumbling Dice and Goat's Head Soup, 73, yielding the hit ballad Angie, were also bestsellers. They released successful albums until the early 80s, including their two largest sellers, Some Girls in 78, featuring the disco-tinged Miss You. Now that, they keep saying it's disco, but it's got more like of a bluesy funk kind of feel to it. I don't see any disco in it, but that's me personally. To each their own, right? And Tattoo You, featuring the hit rocker Start Me Up. If you ask me, I liked Tops better from Tattoo You. Start Me Up was a little dry in the lyrics for me personally. But the Stones are my favorite band. Don't get me wrong. I love them. They then kept the low profile until 89, when they released Steel Wheels, featuring Mixed Emotions, which was followed by Voodoo Lounge, a worldwide number one album that yielded the popular Love Is Strong, Blinded by Rainbows, which was on the Replacements soundtrack, which was really good. Both albums were promoted by a large stadium and arena tours as the Stones continued to be a huge concert attraction. By 2007, they had four of the top five highest-grossing concert tours of all time. Their latest album, Blue and Lonesome 2016, became their 12th UK number one album. Their No Filter tour ran for 2 years, concluding in August 2019, and they have released 30 studio albums, 23 live albums, and numerous compilations. The Rolling Stones estimated record sales of 240 million makes them one of the best-selling music artists of all time. The band has won three Grammy Awards and three Grammy Lifetime Achievement Awards. They were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 1989 and the UK Music Hall of Fame in 2004. In 2008, the Rolling Stones were listed 10th on the Billboard Hot 100 all-time top artist chart. And in 2019, Billboard Magazine ranked them second in their list of the greatest artists of all times based on U.S. chart success. They are ranked ranked fourth on Rolling Stones' list of the greatest artists of all time. They have been a huge part of my life in my music. They have really taught me to go for it. I think the best description that you can read of their books was Life by Keith Richards. I think he put it all down on the line pretty well, regardless of what people think about his heroin use in the past. And then Mick went out to put one out, and I read the first 8 pages, but it was like most of it, it was mostly like talking about how amazing and brilliant Mick was, not like to people to know, but like they were boasting almost. I don't have a problem with Mick either, but the book was a little boasty. So yeah, no, love this album. One of my favorites and my all-time favorite song, Wild Horses, is on it. Hope you guys enjoy it. You're watching Raven's Real Music with Raven Kipling, and we're listening to 1971's The Rolling Stones' Sticky Fingers. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Ah, 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 ah